Hello all my dear students. Today I am going to teach you lesson number 1 of physics. Name of the lesson is matter. We are going to see the reasons why there are different states of matter, that is solid, liquid and gas. The way particles are arranged within matter accounts for different states of matter. In solid, liquid and gas, particles are arranged differently. The force of attraction between the particles give rise to different states of matter. In solid, liquid and gas, force of attraction between the particles are different. Arrangement of particles in solid. You can see here particles arrangement in solid. Force of attraction between the particles is strongest. Particles in the solids are having strong force of attraction between them. You can clearly see here that particles in solid are closely packed. They are so very closely packed that they cannot move. And as they cannot move, particles in solids are just going to vibrate on their place. And that is the reason why solid have fixed shape and size. Example, book. Book is having fixed shape and size. Arrangement of particles in liquid. You can see here arrangement of particles in liquid being shown. Force of attraction between particles are not as strong as those in solid. Here you can see particles are having a little space in between them. So the particles are not going to have strong force of attraction if compared to that of the solid. Particles have limited room to move. You can see this limited room in between the particles. So they can move a little. Particles can slide over one another due to limited space available between them. Due to this, liquids can flow and take the shape of any vessel. You can see here a liquid is being poured in a conical flask and it had taken the shape of the conical flask. Arrangement of particles in gas. You can see the particles arrangement in gas is shown here. As the particles are far off from each other, the force of attraction between the particles are almost negligible or weak as compared to that of solid and liquid. Interparticle distances, you can see, is greater than solid and liquid. In solid, particles were very closely packed. In liquid, they were little far from each other. But you can see here, the particles are far from each other. Gas moves very rapidly and freely and spreads out. Example of incense stick we have already taken. So it prevents gas from taking definite shape and volume. Here you can see different shapes balloons are there in which gas is filled. Here gas has taken the shape of different balloons. Gas can be compressed very easily. So we will revise particles arrangement in solid, liquid and gas. In solid, particles are very closely packed. In liquid, particles are loosely packed. In gas, particles are very loosely packed. Difference between solid, liquid and gas. Solids have definite shape and definite volume. You can see a solid example is shown, that is ice. It is going to have a definite shape and a definite volume. Liquid take the shape of a container and have a definite volume. Here liquid has taken the shape of a glass and has also a definite volume. Gas has no definite shape, no definite volume and fill the available space whatever it is going to get. Interparticle force of attraction in solid is more than liquid and gas. This is so because in solid the particles are very closely packed with each other and therefore interparticle force of attraction in solid is more than liquid and gas. Interparticle force of attraction in liquid is less than solid but more than gas because in liquids, particles are loosely packed if compared to that of the solid and little closely packed if compared to that of gas. Interparticle force of attraction in gas is less than solid and liquid because in gas, particles are very loosely packed and therefore the force of attraction is very less or negligible. Interparticle space in solid. In solid, particles are very closely packed to each other. You can see there is no space in between the particles of the solid. Interparticle space in liquid. Particles in liquid are loosely packed if compared to that of the solid. You can see here there is a little space between the particles of liquid. Interparticle space in gas. In gas, particles are very loosely packed. Compressibility. Solids cannot be compressed. You can see here a solid is shown which is being compressed, but it is not getting compressed. Liquids can be compressed a little. You can see here a liquid is being compressed. It can compressed a little. Whereas gas can be easily compressed. This is a gas which is being compressed and you can see its size has got reduced. That means gas can be easily compressed. Flow. Solids cannot flow and will be on its own place. Liquids can flow, whereas gas can flow in every direction. Thank you.